Here are some of the worst effects plastic has on us and our planet. Number 10, the Great Pacific Garbage Patch. The Great Pacific Garbage Patch is the largest of the five offshore plastic accumulation zones in the world's oceans. It's located halfway between Hawaii and California. It's estimated that 1.15 to 2.41 million tons of plastic are entering the ocean each year from rivers. The stronger, more buoyant plastics show resilience in the marine environment, allowing them to be transported over extended distances. The trash persists at the sea surface as they make their way offshore, transported by converging currents and finally accumulating in the patch. Once these plastics enter the patch, they're unlikely to leave the area until they degrade into smaller microplastics under the effects of the sun, waves, and marine life. The center of the garbage patch has the highest density of trash, and the further boundaries are the least dense. That definitely makes sense, right? Number 9. Whose pollution? It turns out that five countries are the leading contributors to this crisis, and all are in Asia. In a recent report, Ocean Conservancy claims that China, Indonesia, and the Philippines, Thailand, and Vietnam are spewing out as much as 60% of the plastic waste that enters the world's seas. So how did a few Asian countries, many of them comparatively poor, end up churning out much of the plastic waste that swirls around the seas? As Asian economies rise, people have much more cash to blow on Marlboros and Sprites at 7-Eleven. But the junk these habits produce often doesn't end up in legit landfills. In the five Asian countries listed above, only about 40% of the garbage is properly collected. Across Asia, trash is often piled up in communal dumps where stray bits are swept up by the wind and cast into the ocean. Even sanctioned garbage dump sites are supposedly sometimes intentionally set up near rivers that flow into the sea. Apparently, the owners of these dumps are hoping that the waste will intermittently be carried away by heavy rains or currents, refreshing the capacity of the dump to receive more waste. Number 8. Birds. Between entanglement, ingestion, and marine ecosystem damage, the threat of plastic pollution impacts marine species both large and small. But let's not forget our friends in the sky. Scientists have been tracking plastic ingestion by seabirds for decades. In 1960, plastic was found in the stomachs of fewer than 5% of birds. But by 1980, that number had jumped to 80%. For example, the albatross is severely affected by the human-created plastics problem. One might argue that it's intensified because of the way albatross catch their food. They skim the surface of the water with their beak, and along the way, they mistakenly pick up a lot of floating plastic. This plastic is then fed to their chicks. Adults can regurgitate plastic they've swallowed, but chicks are unable to, so it fills up their stomachs. New generations of albatross chicks are struggling to survive because of starvation from being filled with plastic or critical damage that occurs to their gastrointestinal tracts. The highest concentration of plastic in birds can be found in populations in southern Australia, South Africa, and South America, where coastlines are closest to loosely concentrated collections of ocean debris in the southern Pacific, southern Atlantic, and Indian Oceans. Number 7. Rivers. Our seas are choking on plastic. A staggering 8 million metric tons wind up in oceans every year, and unraveling exactly how it gets there is critical. A recent study estimates that more than a quarter of all that waste could be pouring in from just 10 rivers, 8 of them in Asia. The results found by Environmental Science and Technology show that rivers collectively dump anywhere from 0.47 million to 2.75 million metric tons of plastic into the seas every year, depending on the data used in the models. 10 rivers carry 93% of the trash. The Yangtze, Yellow, Hai, Pearl, Amur, Mekong, Indus, and Ganges Delta are in Asia. The Niger and Nile rivers are in Africa. The Yangtze River alone dumps up to an estimated 1.5 million metric tons of plastic waste into the Yellow Sea. These rivers all have two things in common. One is the generally high population living in the surrounding region, and the other is less than ideal waste management processes in place around the rivers. The Yangtze is Asia's longest river and is also one of the world's biggest carriers of plastic pollution to the ocean. Number 6. Human health. Plastics can be made from a selection of many different chemicals depending on application. many of these substances aren't bound to the chemical chain of the plastic, which means that they can migrate under different circumstances as small as a change in temperature or light. Toxic ingredients can evaporate into the air and be breathed in. They can readily absorb into the skin. These chemicals can leach into food or drink and then be ingested. Let's see, what are some examples? Breathing near plastic trash being burned, opening a new plastic item that releases a strong odor, drinking hot coffee from a styrofoam cup, reusing a water bottle, or eating food microwaved in a plastic container. Any of these common practices allow chemicals from plastic to migrate easily into our body. Plastic comes in many forms, but there's general consensus that while plastics are essential to our daily lives, there are serious concerns about its effects on human health. Number 5. Microplastic and ocean life. Microplastics come from a variety of sources, including from larger plastic debris that degrades into smaller and smaller pieces. In addition, microbeads, a type of microplastic, very tiny pieces of manufactured polyethylene plastic that are added as exfoliants to health and beauty products such as soap and toothpastes. These tiny particles easily pass through water filtration systems and end up in the ocean and Great Lakes, posing a potential threat to aquatic life. Microplastic debris floating in the world's oceans could be having a massive impact on marine life. Tiny bits of plastic are having an impact on lugworms, which are an important source of food for many animals. If ocean sediments are heavily contaminated with microplastics, marine lugworms eat less and their energy levels suffer. Also, ingesting microplastic can also reduce the health of lugworms by delivering harmful chemicals. Ingesting the tiny particles can prevent some animals from consuming their natural prey, leading to starvation. Number 4. Bisphenol A. Bisphenol A, or BPA, is a chemical used to make plastics. More precisely, BPA is used to harden plastics, keep bacteria from contaminating foods, and prevent cans from rusting. It's widely used in sports equipment, water bottles, medical devices, and as a coating in food and beverage cans. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention found measurable amounts of BPA in the bodies of more than 90% of the U.S. population studied. The highest estimated daily intakes of BPA occur in infants and children. BPA is more likely to leach out of plastic when its temperature is increased, such as when someone warms up food in the microwave or warms up a baby bottle. In 2012, the FDA banned the use of BPA in baby bottles after several large manufacturers had already voluntarily removed it. Before the voluntary removal and the ban, most plastic baby bottles contained BPA. But even with the ban in baby bottles, two recent studies show that newborns are still being exposed to the chemical. Infants may be exposed to BPA before they're born because of the exposures to BPA by their moms. Number 3. Recycling. Of the 8.3 billion metric tons of plastic that's been estimated to have been produced, an estimated 6.3 billion metric tons has become plastic waste. Only 9% of the waste has been recycled. The vast majority is accumulating in landfills or in the natural environment as litter. In order to tackle the waste problem, we either don't use plastic or we figure out better recycling methods. Many people are often confused by the terms breakdown versus biodegradable. When plastics are broke down, this means one large piece of plastic is reduced into a bunch of smaller pieces of plastic. These smaller pieces of plastic can be consumed by smaller animals, but obviously they're still indigestible. A minority of plastics are biodegradable, which means they can be reduced to their chemical components by, say, your home compost. Other plastics can only be successfully composted by industrial or municipal facilities after first being separated from other non-biodegradable plastics. Unfortunately, most people are confused as to which plastics fall into which category, along with the fact that some areas don't make it convenient to recycle, so many people ultimately don't recycle at all. Number 2. Sea turtles. To sea turtles, a plastic bag looks like a tasty jellyfish. A lost fishing net might look like some harmless seaweed. Because of this confusion, plastic causes roughly 1,000 marine turtle passings each year. They can lead to a number of environmental problems. Plastics are especially dangerous for marine animals as they can become entangled or they can accidentally ingest plastic while feeding. Digestive tracts can become blocked, which can lead to starvation. Plastic straws can also end up in a turtle's nose, obviously blocking breathing. Sea turtle buoyancy disorders, commonly referred to as bubble butts, are also a growing issue. This condition is often caused by trapped gas inside the turtle's digestive system. The harmful decomposition of marine debris is believed to be the cause of many of these cases. Sea turtles that cannot properly submerge in the water will have trouble feeding and become more vulnerable to boat strikes, predation, and entanglements. Number 1. Plastic straws. You guys have heard about the plastic straw ban, right? Because of their size, plastic straws can literally slip through the cracks when going through the recycling process. They often end up in the ocean where they can do damage to sea creatures who mistake them for food, such as the sea turtles we were just talking about earlier. And when straws aren't recycled, they wind up in landfills. Plastic lids, while not ideal, are much easier to recycle. Even if you're not a big straw drinker, the problem is big. According to an estimate by the National Park Service, Americans use millions of straws every single day. As more attention is paid to the issue, companies and cities have taken strides to reduce the amount of straws used each day. Disney already announced plans to eliminate single-use plastic straws and plastic stirrers at all owned and operated locations across the world by mid-2019. Seattle became the first major U.S. city to ban single-use plastic straws and utensils. San Francisco followed with an ordinance that's expected to take effect in 2019. Starbucks announced a move to get rid of plastic straws globally by 2020. Starbucks will switch up to compostable straws to be given to customers upon request. McDonald's has set a goal to shift 100% of guest packaging to renewable or recycled sources by 2025. Here's what's next.
Up until now, I hadn't even thought of those two words strung together, let alone thought of the possibility that something as malicious as that could even be true. Seriously, who would do this? Who on earth would buy this? Well, there are Chinese entrepreneurs who somehow ground up aborted babies to sell as energy.